Hi, today I'll take you through the surgical steps involved in the harvesting of temporalis muscle flap for reconstruction of palate of maxillary defect. This is a 68-year-old lady with multiple comorbidities and diagnosed as carcinoma palate, clinically T2N0M0. The lesion involves the left posterolateral aspect of the heart palate, left upper alveolus, and crossing the midline at the palate. She underwent a wide excision of the palatal lesion and inferior partial maxillectomy. And this is the defect after resection. The zygomatic arch is marked as a landmark. The approach is basically a pre-auricular incision with a temporal extension. The incision begins at the level of zygomatic arch. A monopolar cautery is used to place the incision. The incision is deepened till the temporalis fascia is identified. The temporal incision is confined to the hairline for cosmetic purpose. Profuse bleeding is expected at this stage because of the high vascularity of the scalp. Once the temporalis fascia is identified, the dissection is continued superficial to the fascia to raise the skin flap. The aim of this dissection is to expose the entire temporalis muscle, which occupies the temporal fossa. Superiorly, the temporalis muscle is inserted onto the temporal line. The dissection is continued in all directions till the temporal line is reached. The entire temporalis muscle has been exposed now, and you can see the temporalis fascia and the underlying muscle. The fascia and the pericranium are incised, and the superior edge of the muscle is identified. A subperiosteal dissection is done to detach the muscle from the bone. This step can be performed either using a periosteal elevator or a cautery. The cautery should be held close to the bone to avoid damage to the muscle. The entire muscle has to be detached from the temporal fossa. The anteriormost fibers of the muscle are detached from the lateral frontal region. You can see the lateral wall of the orbit from where the muscle is detached. Similarly, it is detached from the posterior end of the zygomatic arch. Finally, the fascia is detached from the superior border of the zygomatic arch. Care should be taken to avoid injury to the frontal branch of facial nerve. Just above the zygomatic arch, the temporalis fascia splits into two layers. A superficial layer that runs lateral to the arch and a deep layer that goes medially. The space between these two layers is occupied by the temporal fat pad. During the procedure, as we approach the zygomatic arch, the superficial layer of the temporalis fascia is dissected and further dissection is carried out medial to the arch. By doing this, the frontal branch of facial nerve can be preserved. Now you can see the zygomatic arch. The fascia and the muscle has been completely detached and freed from the arch. This step is very important for the adequate mobilization of the flap. The flap harvesting is almost completed. Now it is ready to be transferred to the oral cavity, medial to the zygomatic arch.
We are introducing one Babcock.
A Babcock is inserted medial to the zygomatic arch from the oral cavity to the donor site. The distal edge of the muscle is held using the Babcock forceps. And it is gently pulled into the oral cavity. The flap is transferred to the oral cavity and inserting is done with a 2-0 Weichel. This is the immediate posterior view of the flap. This is the 8 months posterior picture of another patient whose palate was reconstructed with a temporalis flap. Thank you for watching the video and have a nice day.